Thank you, eighth graders, for skipping your third period class, some of you today, and coming, because this is an honor and a privilege that we get to have this guest presenter for us today. Obviously, we're learning about the Native American culture, so one of the great things that goes along with it is drumming, and there's different types, and I'm going to let Mr. Johnson here explain that to you, but we get the privilege of having him tell us a little bit about it, and then do some demonstrating for us today, okay? So, as always, I know you can be respectful eighth graders, so please help me welcome Mr. Johnson today.
Lamaya Pelo, thank you for that introduction and that warm greeting. I'm gonna teach you guys a little bit about the drum. First of all, I want you guys to say a little bit of Lakota for me, okay? So after me, say, Chanchega.
Chanchega.
All right, I'm gonna teach you about the drum, but I'm gonna relate it to an idea throughout this whole time. And it's called medicine, good medicine. It's very powerful, okay? So first of all, look to your left and smile to the person as big as you can. Now look to your right and give a nice, gentle handshake to the next one. All right. Okay. Now, the way you feel when you give that handshake and that smile is good medicine. And how you are feeling is contagious to that person. So if you shake that person's heart, shake that person's hand with a good heart and good intentions, you're actually giving them good medicine. But if you feel not quite centered, or if you're a little bit off, that can go to that person also. So really focus on how you feel on a daily basis and take care of yourself so that you can be good medicine to the people around you. That's one of the theories with this drum and also medicine. So I'm gonna start off with a little song here. Carry ourselves on a daily basis, we remind ourselves how powerful we are and what kind of medicine we are. We can be very good medicine to people around us. We can take care of others. We can show good examples. We can say kind things. And we're very, very powerful in that way. And in the same way, this drum is also very powerful. I'm going to show you a way to remember that. What shape is this drum? Okay, I want you to think of yourselves as this drum right here. And you being how you want to be. Think about how you want to be and how you want to make others feel. Because that's one of the most important things in this world and in this life, is how you make other people feel. Okay, so I want you to think of yourself in a good place, centered. Or maybe we're not. Maybe we're not centered. Maybe we're having a little bit of a rough time with school. Maybe we're having a rough time getting on time to class. Or we're having a problem with math or science. It's okay, because we can always come back to the place in the middle within this drum. within yourselves on where you want to be. You can always move in the right direction. If you're struggling with science, you know what? You can pick up a science book during reading time. Maybe it's not the science book, but something related to science or math. You can read a book about math. You can always be moving in the right direction. But always do it in a good, relaxed manner, okay? Well, this drum, I'm going to tell you a little story on a little bit about Lakota culture. We have the four directions that are very important to us in the Lakota culture. And the first direction we always acknowledge is the west. And it's Wioch Beatakia. And that's where they say our spirit comes from. It comes from the west. It comes in here. And we journey through life with our spirits, and we take care of our spirits. And what they say is our spirits are most vulnerable right now. Not while they're in the spirit world, but right here while they're with us in our bodies, while we're walking this path in life. Because our spirit has to feel negative energy, it has to feel jealousy, it has to feel anger, it has to feel inadequacy, like maybe you don't feel like you're good enough for something. It has to feel all these negative things, but we have to take care of it. We have to take care of our spirit the way we feel so that we'll be good medicine for other people around us. And that's why we have plenty of medicines to take care of ourselves. And this drum is one medicine. Song's one medicine. Water, very good medicine. Food, very good medicine. Kindness, honesty. Very good medicine. Those are the good things. It's not hard for us to decide what's good and what's bad. That's easy. Sometimes what's hard is staying in that middle or going to that point where we want to be, in the middle of a good person and good medicine. We don't ever want to hurt other people. We don't want to hurt other people. We want to take care of other people. Because in our culture, we have this thing called Madakuye Oyasin. And it's true, we're all related. We all go through similar things. And we have to get to that point where we understand everybody, Madakuye Oyasin includes everybody. We're all related. And the most important thing is how we make other people feel, how we take care of others. So, I want you to think of this drum as a life. You guys aren't the first students to come into this auditorium, and you guys are on your way to high school. You guys have been through elementary school. I'm up here somewhere, kind of getting up there. I'm 35 years old. But if you look on this drum, and you guys are right here, somewhere in this area in your lives, you look back and there's people looking up to you. There's a lot of people looking up to you. Everybody is looking up to you that's younger, the seventh graders, the sixth graders. You have to really find your strength to be in that middle so that you're guiding them well. And then you look up here ahead of you, you have relatives and you have high schooler students that have already been where you're at. And they're trying and they're doing the best they can to guide you. And they're encouraging you and they're wanting you to go a good path. Then you have the elders up here that have been all the way around in this life, and they are there for you to look up to. And they've been through all these troubled times, and they've made it through, and they've done all these things. And you have responsibilities towards them. You have responsibilities for the next generations to come. And it's just what I want you to do is think about that center, you know, and really who you want to be, okay? So, usually when I greet people, I greet them in the Lakota language because that's my bloodline, Lakota. So, we're gonna learn a little Lakota today, okay? All right, so I'm gonna greet you guys in my language. It's how matakia pichon, dewa shtena pe chuza pelo. Wichasha Johnson, Emacha Abalo. Kanhi Okute Hemataha. Yash Wana Sufaz Elwati. Roosevelt, Owaiowa Ekta, Wawashi Echamuelo. Inawayeki, Norman Carpenter, Na Atewayeki, Robert Johnson, Echamuelo. So, what I just said was, you know, I greet you guys with a good heart and good intentions. I'm here and I'm thinking, well, I don't really know what I'm going to say to these guys. But I want to make it good, because that's what we do. We're good, try to share good things with people. And I acknowledge my mom and my dad. Well, I made a trip to Portland, Oregon, and I realized something very, very amazing about the native cultures. The native people across this continent are very, very different depending on where you go. And I'm kind of talking to mostly the Native American students here, because I want to encourage you to do something very important. I went to Portland, Oregon, and there's coastal tribes over there. And they welcomed us with their cultural food, their salmon. Ooh, their salmon is so good. Dried salmon, delicious, delicious salmon. They welcomed us with their songs, and their songs are very, very different than our songs here. And they welcomed us with their language. And the first thing they did was they introduced themselves in their language. So that's one of the things I want you guys to be able to do, is think about your own cultural language and greet yourself, or greet others with that language. At the same time, those coastal cultures were so much the same as the Lakota, Dakota, Nakota people of these areas, these plains, with a lot of the same ideas. And what I encourage you guys to do, the native people here, the native students here to do, is to learn a song or two. Learn about your cultural foods, that buffalo. Wonderful, wonderful tasting food. Timsila, that wild turnip, delicious and beautiful. The papa, dried meat, and the wojapi, oh my goodness, it's so good. If you're able to greet people when they come to see you, be able to try to offer them some food like that, some good food, and maybe a song and an introduction in your language. So, let's see here. So, one thing we're going to do here is practice a little bit of Lakota. I'm a Lakota language teacher, so I want you guys to say after me, repeat after me. Medakiyepi. Chante. Washte, Nape, Chiyuzapi. All right, you just said, hello, my relatives. I'm greeting you today with a good heart. And when you say that, you're reminding yourself that every day you wake up, you are a medicine to people, and you want to be that. Have that good heart when you meet them. Okay, so let's see here. let's see here. What do you guys want to do now? Another song? Okay. Yeah. All right. So, all right. I'm gonna ask you how the song makes you feel when I'm done. Look to your neighbor and say, you smell like fabric. Don't forget, that is a fabric. That is a, hey, listen up here. That is a wonderful compliment, okay? All right. A lot of these songs we sing are reminders There's a lot of reminders in these songs that we are very important to the people around us, and that people are looking towards us to be good role models. And that's one of the things, one of the values that we have as a Dakota people is our courage and our bravery. It's world renowned. People in Germany, they look over here to the Lakota warriors like Sitting Bull and Crazy Horse, and they value that courage that we have in life and as people. And one of the things it takes courage to do is to be kind. It takes a lot of courage to be kind, and it takes a lot of courage to meet your challenges. That's where it's a good place to put your courage. And we're telling you guys, a lot of us that are up here ahead of you guys, that are made it through high school and college, are telling you, come this way, stay in school, work hard. It's not easy sometimes, but keep working at it. Don't give up. That's where you want to be, is that in that right direction. So, all right, here we go, one more song. A lesson about this way of singing songs is this too. We don't sing to impress, and we don't sing to perform. Every time we sing, it's to help, it's to share. There's no good or bad singers. Everybody has their own voice, and they add it to the air. Okay? So whenever you're asked to sing around a Lakota drum, you just add your voice. So, you know, however you want to do it. And feel the song. The song comes to you not by thinking about it. It comes to you by feeling it. So relax. And if you guys can, just hum along gently to the song. If you might, even pick it up a little bit by the end. Okay? So here we go. This song here, I always kind of remember things last minute, but this song right here is a song composed as a gift, and I'm pretty sure it's been it's welcomed to be shared as medicine to everybody around. That's why I'm going to sing it today.
Yo, le mie cha te.
purpose to remind you about humility and the way you want to walk in this life, on this journey. And that song right there says, take a look over here. I'm having a rough time today. I have a hard time translating it, but remember that I'm walking in this way looking for peace on this world. That's what that song says. And there's an additional part to that song that says, everything returns to harmony. Everything returns to harmony. So, anyways, let's see here. I always like to spread the Lakota language. There's a movement for language revitalization going worldwide. Many countries in Europe and all across the United States are becoming involved in the language revitalizations. They say that the last person of a language dies every 3 weeks, and that with that person, the language dies. So when you hear another language, value that language, and with respect, try to listen and learn it. So, all right. Well, I just want you guys to remember, the drum is medicine. You guys are medicine. Songs are medicine, and what you say is very powerful. Very powerful. So continually work on how you feel and how you treat others, okay? So, in Lakota, we always say, Doksha Ake. So after me, Doksha Ake.
Doksha Ake.
All right, that means see you later. If not today, sometime, right? Okay, so, Wana Miglushtan Yelo. I'm done now. So, thank you very, very much.
Anything about drumming specifically or songs?
Okay,
Malia?
What's your drum made out of?
This drum here is made out of, looks like hide. I think it's I think this is made out of cow. But a lot of times they're made out of buffalo, elk, or elk. Yeah, thank you.
There's somebody else talking to add real quick. Okay, yep, Xavier.
Well, where are you from?
I'm from Crow Creek, home of the brave.
I have a question for you.
Yeah.
Traditionally, when you do the larger drum circle, is there a rhyme or reason to how many people sit around the drum, or who gets to play, or is there kind of a about that?
The question was, is there a certain amount of people, or is there any rhyme or reason of how many people sit around the drum? And I think one of the cool things about the drum is that it's round, and you can always seem to fit one more person. So everybody's always welcome. You might have to have a stick that's 1.5 mile long, but you can fit the whole Sioux Falls around one drum if you wanted to. So that's the idea, though. Oh, everyone's always welcome to the drum.
Okay. Anyone else have any questions? Okay, now please help me in thanking
you. I hope you guys have a wonderful day.
Johnson, Roosevelt, Owaiwa Ekta, Washi Chamuelo, Lakotia, Wanjina, Nupa, Naha, NAC, Wanjina, Nupa, Wounspe, which we chakia, Wounspe, wa, we chakia lo. Atewayeki, Robert Johnson, Echapina, Inawayeki. Norma Carpenter e chapi. Chichapi nupa mayonche. Chungshiwayeki teya e chapi. Naha. Chungshiwayeki babi chik ala e chapi. My relatives, what I just said was I graded you in a language indigenous to this area. It's the Lakota language. It's a language that was spoken in this area a lot, not too long ago. But it's a language that they say is in danger. They say that one language, about every 3 weeks, the last speaker of that language passes away, and with that person goes the language. We teach the Lakota language over at NAC, and we're very, very grateful to have that there, or over at Roosevelt, and we're very grateful to have that. We also might have it in this school a little bit also, but we're part of a language revitalization that's occurring across the nation, and it's across the world. There's a lot of support for language revitalization because there's very valuable things in languages. What I said was Metakiapi, Chante, Washte, Nape, Chiuzapelo. And with that greeting in Lakota, it reminds us that we have to try our best to stay centered so that we are treating people around us very good. It's hard sometimes, but we always need to remind ourselves we affect others around us a lot. And Chante is heart. Washte is a good heart. Nape is a hand. Chiuzapelo is greet. I'm reaching out to you with a good heart. And in order to say that, you have to continually practice being happy, continuously practice being honest, and always listen to that inner self that tells you the truth of what's good and what's bad. Before you listen to anybody around you, listen to yourself in your heart and what's there. It's telling you the truth. And we all know good from bad. And sometimes it's hard to act that way. But we always got to try to pull ourselves back to the center where we know we are being good medicine to people around us. When we play sports, winning is fun. But being honest and playing a good game is more important. Succeeding is good, it's very good, but that comes with being centered and doing well and helping others around you because you gain from them. So, anyways, I'm going to sing about three songs today, and I'm going to tell you a couple little lessons also about this, and I'm going to relate it to this drum right here, okay? So, what I said was, we are all medicine in this philosophy. And we can be good medicine. The people around us, how you think and how you feel, without even saying a word, can affect others. If you work on how you feel and you feel good, that can spread without even saying one word. You don't have to say nothing. So we're a medicine. And what I always like to recognize is the most basic of things, which makes everything good. And the first thing that we always recognize is water. Water is a very good medicine. If without water, we become unbalanced, and we become dehydrated, and it becomes very detrimental to our health. So when we drink our water, we take care of our water, we're very thankful for it. And we drink it and we say, look, we even say it sometimes, thank you for this water. I'm giving my body this water because it's good. Accept this water as a medicine in the body. Food, good food, another medicine. Love, very powerful medicine. and ourselves, we're medicine. Okay, so what I want you to do right now is look to you. What? Behold. I'm going to sing three songs, okay? When I start singing these songs, listen carefully, but listen with an open heart, and start to, if you can, kind of pick up on the tune a little bit. We don't write these songs down. None of these songs are ever written down. We always just share them, and people learn them from feeling the songs. And then you add your voices like that. So when I sing these songs, all I want you to do is listen to them and to kind of feel the rhythm, feel whatever it is. I'll explain it afterwards, okay? So, anyways, be good medicine. Look to somebody. Look to your Look to your right, except if you're on the right-hand side. Look, wait patiently, and then look to your left. But give your neighbor a handshake with a good heart. Have a good heart. All right. All right. Be good medicine. Be good medicine. All right, here we go. Aloha, ichi, wanji. Thank you. Thank you for listening with a good heart and open heart and open mind. That song right there is a flag song. That's a very unique song that recognizes our American flag that we live under. And it's called the Lakota flag song. Within those words, it says, under that flag right there, we will live and we will grow. And that flag will never waver. And this is why I do what I do. We do things for others around us. We do things for our community. We do things for our families. We do things for our country. We do things for all of our relatives everywhere around the world. We're all related in Lakota way. It's called Medakuye Oyase. So, I want to share a little idea, philosophy about this drum here. When I say everything's related, we're all related, Medakuye Oyase, I look at this drum as my relative. And I look at it as very sacred because it's been places with me and it's given healing to people. And it's picked up negative feelings, but it's very sacred. And it also was given by the cow that was, this is alive. This is alive. This was alive at one time. It gave its life for me to be able to share my song or our songs as medicine. So it's very sacred to me. So here's the philosophy in Lakota. There's a circle here. Okay? And some people say that the spirit that we walk with, not just our body, but our spirit, comes in. We comes into this body when we're born, when we're very, very young. Not when we're born, maybe before we're born. Sometime, very early, comes into this world, and it goes on a journey. You guys are on a journey right now. And it goes in this journey, in this circle of motion. But there's no beginning and no end in this motion, in this circle. What they say is that during this journey, our spirit is the most vulnerable. You have to protect your spirit every single day because it has to deal with negativity, has to deal with jealousy, has to deal with anger, has to deal with being scared, uncertainties, shame. Everything, a lot of these negative things that our body, that our spirit goes to while we're in this body. They say it's the most difficult time. That's why it's most important while we're in this body to take care of our spirits. take care of ourselves and to be good medicine for ourselves and for others. And on this journey, you guys are in middle school. You guys are looking ahead to high school and beyond. You guys are looking back, and there's you guys have little brothers, little sisters, little maybe nieces and nephews, little cousins. They're looking up to you guys, and they're counting on you guys to be good students in middle school. They're counting on you guys know what's good. You gotta just try your best. Always try your best. Continually try to get back on a good path. I'm up here somewhere as an adult. I have two kids, Lutea and Little Body, and they're looking up to me. They're counting on me. And I have also have elders that are looking back and saying, hey, you can do this, do good. Also in the spirit world, they say, we have all of our ancestors with us at all times in this Lakota value way. So whenever you need help, they say, in Lakota way, you can just ask for help. And some people say, just look up. Humbly ask for help. All right, so I want you to look to your neighbor. Give him a nice, kind smile and one compliment. That song right there reminds us that we are vulnerable, that we go through negative times as we walk on this earth. Maka anka owa mani. It's while I walk on this earth, I'm having difficult times sometimes. But it's okay to acknowledge that. It's okay to acknowledge that you're having, that someone's annoying you. But you don't want to treat them negatively. It's okay that somebody, that you're struggling with math or science. It's okay. Because you're acknowledging the idea that you're having a struggle and that you'd like to get back on it, on a good path, on the right direction. Meaning, pick up your pencil, take a deep breath, work in the right direction. Okay? So, let's see here. Well, what I want to do is give you guys a little Lakota language lesson. Then what I'll do is end with a song, one more song, and wrap it up. So, when we say, Mataku yepi. Go ahead. Mataku yepi. We're saying, first of all, you're related to me. Not like brother and sister, but we're related. Think of the universe. Looking this way, we are all related. Because we all share the same planet. We share the same air. We share pain when we pinch ourselves. When we get hurt, our feelings get hurt, we share those things. So we're related that way. So, chante. Our heart. It's our heart. It's an important part of our bodies because it drives us. They say, you have a lot of heart, son. Because you just you know what you want to do. Washteh. A good way. Good way. No, without a doubt. A good way. Nape.
Nape.
Hand. Chi.
Chi.
Chi is a prefix changing. Specifically relating me to you. Yuza kalo. Or no, yuza. Just say yuza.
Yuza.
Alright, I secure your hand with a good heart. That's all you're saying. And you're putting away all negativity when you say that. Okay? And we always try to get back to a good place. Right here in the middle. Alright? So, two compliments to your neighbor. Go ahead. That's a challenge. All right. Okay. Lecha wayaka po. You know what? I'm going to give you guys one little pointer also. A lot of you guys in the future, we'll have to give presentations and talk in front of people and maybe go to, maybe in front of thousands of people. Who knows where you guys might end up these days. But one thing that will make you a good speaker is to be a good listener. While you realize that it's my turn to speak, you turn it off and say, okay, that's good. And you go back and you're right here. Just you pay attention. Just a side note, I'm being a good speaker and a good listener. Okay, so. Last thing about this Lakota singing and drumming. It's not, it's really neat because there's a lot of lessons to be taught just with this drum. I mean, I'm serious. We could talk all day and there could be people lined up at the door ready to share their lessons with you about this drum because that's how many there are. But one of the things I want to share with you guys is the awesomeness of singing. All of us have a voice that somebody wants to hear, okay? So practice your voices, even if it's just in the shower, okay? But you guys, it's good. Somebody will want to hear your voice. So always practice singing. It's a great gift. And we don't sing this way to impress. We sing to share and to help make people feel good. That's the only reason. We're not to impress. So, last song. I'm just going to share one more song with you. This is one that's meant, that's intended to, intended as good medicine to be shared with people. And that's why I'll do that.
Yeah.
Kashela wa maya kayo yo le miecha tehia nawajielo heya he uche makata weche shnaya wa kwa kwa wa uelo heyo. Brief explanation of the song. It's kind of hard for me, but basically, this, a lot of these songs are reminders of being good medicine, taking care of people around you. This song says, take a look over here at me. I am having difficulties again with what I'm doing, but it's trying to find that path. We do have a lot of difficulties. We're trying to find out who we are, how we want to be. It's difficult, and we're growing up all the time. But it says, it reminds me, the last part of the song says, I walk on this earth seeking peace. And that's not a bad thing to do, seeking peace. And I'll leave you guys with that. So, thank you guys for being such a great, great audience, and be good medicine today. Yeah, we have four classes at Roosevelt that are electives. NAC 1 and NAC 2, which are Native American culture, current events, and history. It's an elective. Both classes, if you were to take them, we go on an awesome field trip to sacred sites in the Black Hills, in which we have overnight stay, and we do a variety of things, and it's always an awesome time. We do Lakota 1 and Lakota 2. We're part of a huge, like I said, language revitalization. They say that Lakota is in a endangered state. Our average speaker is is in their 50s. We have very few speakers that are teenagers and young men, and babies are very few of them. They say that that's in a endangered area, but we're a part of strengthening that language in that classroom, and it's really, really cool. We have a lot of fun, and one of the things that we're attempting to do is compete in a Lakota Language Bowl, in which we spend time with others from around the probably state. That'd be like really cool. People from around the world would come. No, there will be people from around the world there. But anyways. Competing with others that are doing the same thing, strengthening a language, doing something very good. And that's what we do there. We have a great time learning every single day. Yeah?
Is it at Lincoln?
It's at Lincoln and at Washington and at Roosevelt. Yes. Yes.
Who can take your classes?
Anybody can take my classes. Anybody can take my classes. Yeah? You have another question? No. We have a... I teach only at Roosevelt, and we have another teacher that teaches at Lincoln in Washington. His name is Mr. Easter.
How many of you are eighth graders right now? Raise your hand. These are all the kiddos that are heading. How many of you are going to Roosevelt? So we majority be mostly into Lincoln. But for those of you that are going to Roosevelt, guys, the reason why I bring this up to you, this is after seventh graders, this will be you next year. The reason I'm telling you this now, you will be registering for high school classes around January. So if this is something that intrigues you, it is an elective that you can take some time throughout your high school career. Or do you have kids of every grade that take your class?
Oh yes, every grade, all the time.
So even if you don't have, you are not Lakota in your heritage, but this is a culture that intrigues you, it is something that they still encourage you to take. Something that it's open to anybody, and I know that they're trying to build their program. Like you said, they're trying to revitalize this Lakota language, and I know we've been spending a lot of time in humanities talking about this, but if it's something that even remotely interests you at all, it's something to take into consideration to take as an elective some time while you're in college or high school.